Jets here and welcome back to my channel. As you can see on the description box, today we are going to have the part 3 of our live work tutorial. So I hope that you are already done watching the part 1, which is the basic tutorial about live worksheets if you still don't have an account, and then the part 2, which is more specific about fill in the blank, drop select box, and multiple choices. This time I will introduce to you 4 options in making your worksheets online, and these are the check boxes. Next is join with arrows, or commonly known as matching type. Next is drag and drop, and the last one is the puzzle box. So if you have this type of test in your worksheet, then please continue watching as I will walk you through on how are you going to incorporate this one online. So without further ado, let's start and go to our account. First things first, we need to prepare the worksheet. So I already have here the check boxes, join with arrows or the matching type, drag and drop, and the word search puzzle. So we need to export this one or change the file into PDF so we could use it and it would be downloaded in the live worksheet website. So there you go. Now let's go to the website now. So I already have my account logged in. Let's just go directly to get started. And then choose file. You know, oftentimes I am encountering this kind of error. But as what I've mentioned before, you just have to refresh it. And there you go. We're ready. For the check boxes, what we're going to do is we're going to make a box in each number. As you can see in the direction, put the check if the spelling of the following type of energy is correct. So the command that we're going to use here is the word tick, colon, and then yes for the correct answer, and no for the wrong answer. So again, just remember the command to use in check boxes is the word tick, colon. That's how easy it is. Let's proceed to the join with arrows, or commonly known as the matching type. What we're going to do here is we're going to put boxes on the choices. So as you can see in the direction, match the different power stations to each pictures. So we're going to make boxes over the pictures as well. And there you go. Now the command that we're going to use here is the word join colon followed by a number. So for example, we have here join number 1, join 2, join colon 3. To match it to its correct answer, we just have to write the same command and the same number. For solar power station, that's join colon 1. For hydroelectric power station, that's join colon 2. And for geothermal power station, that's join colon 3.
That's it for our matching time. Next is the drag and drop. Now let's read the direction first. Complete the sentences below. Drag the word or words to the line and drop to complete the sentence. So what we're going to do here is to make a box on the words that we are going to drag. And then we are also going to make a box on the drop area. There you go. Now the command that we're going to use here are drag and drop. So first we use the word drag, colon followed by a number. So these are the words that we are going to drag to the line. So let me just change this one into one, since this is the number one. Drag colon number two. And then drag colon number three. Now the next command that we're going to use is the word drop. Then same number with number one, dropped two, drop colon three. When you leave a room, you should turn off all the lights to conserve electricity. So drag and then drop. Same goes to number two and number three. Now let's proceed to word search puzzle. What we're going to do here is we are just going to cover all the letters with one box. Now the command that we're going to use here is the word search, and an option will automatically pop up. So it will ask for number of rows and number of columns. So we have 6 rows and 6 columns, and then save it. That's how you're going to do it. And then after that, you just have to click all the words that the students need to search. And then the guess. Once you're done writing all the answers and the commands, then let's go to the preview. So preview is very important because there are some instances that you will have some wrong answers or you miss some of the commands. Like for example, here in test 3, there is something wrong with the word money because it's not highlighted. So this is supposed to be drag and drop. Let's check. So as you can see, we cannot drag the word money. So what we need to do here is we need to go back to edit and then check what's the problem. Okay, here we go. We forgot to put the colon here. So colon three. And then we're good to go. Let's go back to preview and check it again. And then, so as you can see here, we can now drag the word money. And for the word puzzle, the students just need to click all the words that they need. And there you go, 10 over 10. It's time to save it. So let's just keep it private. Click this one. And then write the title. Okay, and then save. And our worksheet is now ready for our kids to answer. Let's try.
Now, if you find any error after saving it, nothing to worry because we can still edit it. You just have to go to your name account, go to my worksheets, and then click edit. And there you go. The error here is that this should not be coil, but it should be oil. So we just have to remove that one and then save it again. Now you will be given an option to change the title of the worksheet, and if you still want to keep it private, and then if you want to replace the existing worksheet or save it as a new worksheet. So you will be given an option for that. So save worksheet. And that's it. Let's check it again. Let's answer the error only. Let's check. It's already correct. So that's it, guys. That's how you are going to use the live worksheets. Actually, there are many things that you could do. You just have to go to tutorial, and then there are many guides here. Okay, as you can see here, there are also listening exercises, speaking exercises, open answer questions, and you can even add MP3 files, YouTube videos, PowerPoints, add links. So there are many things that you could do here. All you have to do is to explore the website. That's it, and you will learn a lot of things in the website. There you go, guys. Thank you very much for tuning in on my channel and for watching my videos. Now, if you like the three videos that I make about live worksheet tutorial, then please do click the like button and of course the subscribe button. Please consider clicking the notification bell as well, so the next time that I will upload new videos for you, then you will be notified. Once again, this is Miss Jets. I hope you had a good day. Rise and shine. Bye.